Well, welcome to tonight's broadcast of Rochester Zebra Football. Tonight, the C team takes on the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings C team, visiting Barnhart Field for the first time this year. Tomorrow night, of course, will be the big contest, varsity Rochester Zebras against the varsity Vikings over at Tippecanoe Valley. So we're off with the kick here. Gets past the first return guy. He's got a lane. Zebra's struggling to bring him down. They swarm him, though. See if we can get a number on that. Looks like the ball's going to be placed at the 45-yard line. First and 10, Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Hand off to the far side. Brought down. Your gain of a couple. Going to bring up second down. /79 Dylan Weaver leading the front four up there for the Zebras. Number 35 up under center for the Viking. That's Noah Miller. Hands off again to the far side. Solid run. Let's see where they spot it. And that's going to be a first down, Vikings. First and 10 from the Zebra 45. Pitch to the near side. Find some running room, enough for a first down. That's going to take him down to about the 33-yard line. Or 45-yard runner there for Tippecanoe Valley. That's Dakota Gaff. Dakota's a 5'5 freshman, 126-pound, wide receiver most of the time. Also a defensive back for the Vikings. Penalty on the play, however. It's going to back the Vikings up. First and 15 for the Vikings. Pitch to the far side. Brought down immediately by the Zebras in the backfield. Dylan Weaver's there, but number 5, Drew Saylor's made the tackle. Another loss for the Vikings. Going to bring up second down. About 17. 7:55 to go here in the first. Scoreless ball game so far. As the Vikings are on their first drive of the game. Scott Sager here with you with RTC TV. Glad you're joining us. Looks like a false start by the Vikings. We'll wait for the call. And there it is. False start. It's going to back them up 5 more. It's going to make it 2nd and 22 for the Vikings. Rolls out to the near side for the pass. Tosses it up. It was anybody's ball there. Lands incomplete. Going to bring up 3rd down for the Vikings. So third and 22. Hand off to the near side. Find some room. A good run. That's number 45 for the Vikings. Dakota Gaff. It's going to be fourth down. Back in Zebra territory, though. Ball sitting at about the 42, 43-yard line. Just under seven to go here in the first quarter. Vikings send a man to the near side. Go with a handoff to the far side, and he is off to the races. My goodness. Good blocking there by Tippecanoe Valley. Enough for a first down. Hand off to the near side. Brought down by number 24 for the Zebras. That was 34 on the carry. So Jace Potter with the carry. And Harrison Harrell with the tackle. Still a good run. It's going to bring up second and about two for the Vikings. Hand off near side. Couple of blockers in front. Enough to get a nice gain. Going to bring up first and goal for the Vikings inside the 10-yard line. And off, fumble on the exchange. Tippecanoe Valley recovers as number 45 was able to land on that. That's Dakota Gaff again. So we're at 5 minutes left. Second and goal for the Vikings. Number 80 comes out. Eighty-five is Luke Prater coming in with the play for the Vikings. They send 85 to the near side. A roll out option. Zebras take that down quickly. It's number 72 for the Zebras. Jacob Mark. Going to bring up third down for the Vikings. To the far side, but some great penetration. That's number 24 of the Zebras, Harrison Harrell, with the tackle on the blitz there. So brings up fourth down inside at 3 minutes and 30 seconds here for the Vikings. Fourth and goal. Zebras backed him up to just about the 15-yard line. Big play for the defense here. Send number 9 to the far side out wide. 85 to this side. Flag on the play. Looks like a false start. False start on the Vikings. That's going to back them up five more. Going to make it fourth and goal from the 20-yard line. Rolls to his right for the pass. Looks left. Throws it up. Incomplete. Zebras will take over. A little too much air underneath the pass. Allowed the Zebras to get underneath and make the defensive play. Zebras will take over first and 10 with 2:34 to go here in the first quarter. Scoreless so far. Drew Sailors leads his troops up to the line of scrimmage. We've got one man to the far side, one to the near. Low snap. Sailors picks it up, just tries to salvage a yard or so out of it, and ends up back to the line of scrimmage. Going to bring up second down and 10 for the Zebras. Twins to the near side. Pitch to the near side. Swarmed by the Vikings. See if we can get a number there on the initial hit and tackle. It was Baker with the carry. Looks like number one for the Vikings. Dwight Conley with the tackle, along with a lot of his teammates. Going to bring up third down for the Zebras inside of a minute 30. Back to pass, tries to hit the seam, intercepted. Heads up play by number 29 for the Vikings. That's Jalen Potter with the interception. Going to give the Vikings the ball back at the Zebra 36-yard line with a new set of downs and a minute to go here in the first quarter. Fumbled, handoff, headed towards the far side. Flag on the play. Looks like the Vikings recovered the ball. Let's see the call. They are actually giving it to the Zebras, who came up with the ball from the bottom of the pile. Let's see about the call. The flag was a holding, declined. Zebras take over. Looks like they're going to spot it right at the 40 for the Zebras. Hand off. Didn't quite have control of the ball. Looks like he's held on to it, though. Enough to get him just back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard. Yep, they're marking it about a yard. So it's going to bring up second and 9 for the Zebras. Hand off up the middle. Nice gain for a first down. That was 24 Harrison Harrell for the Zebras. Good blocking up front. That's going to do it for the first quarter here. A scoreless first quarter. Zebras marching. They got it into Viking territory now. We'll be back after this. Back from the quarter break. Switch direction. Zebras first and 10 after that fumble recovery. Snap a little high. Pitch to the outside. He's got some room. Nice run by number 86 for the Zebras. That's Bryce Lehman back this week after an injury, being out for injuries last week. Good to see him back. Good run to get it started. Going to be second and one, it looks like. Not quite enough for the first down. C-team struggled against Northfield last week. Week before that, had a great win over Whitco here at Barnhart Field. Looked like some confusion in the backfield. Lehman wasn't sure which way to go with it, and heavy penetration by the Vikings. Among others, number 70 leading the tackle, that's Colton McCain. So that's going to back the Zebras up. Looks like it's going to be third and six. A long six, let's call it, with 8:40 to go here in the second. Great look at the line of scrimmage as they're right in front of the cameras here. Lehman with the handoff, the rollout to the near side, the pass. And just from my gut call, it looks like it's going to be enough for a first down, but they may need to measure.
Close to the first down.
They're going to give him the first down based on the yardage. Might have helped if they were on the Zebra sidelines there. So first and 10 for the Zebras. Man in motion. Gets the handoff. Takes it to the far side. Got some room. Good gain there. Looks like number 22 for the Zebras. Of course, that is Justin Riston. He's had some good games in the C-team level this year for the Zebras. So second and about a yard for the Zebras. Number 49 coming out for the Zebras. Garrett Gray came out. Heavy penetration there by the Vikings. Number 58 led the way, along with number 70. Give you some names here. 58 not listed. 70 is Colton McCain. It's going to take the Zebras back, second and seven from the Valley 36. Excuse me, going to make it third and seven. Number 24 with the carry around the right side. Couldn't quite get around. That's Harrison Heller, Harrell. And brought down by Jalen Potter for the Vikings. Going to bring up fourth down. Lehman back in for the Zebras. Fourth and eight. High snap for Sailors. He's rushed. He's going to go down. Taken down by the Viking, number 70. Clear back at the 48-yard line. Colton McCain again. Good play out of him in this first half. So the penalty was declined there. just inside Zebra territory here for the Vikings as they take over first and 10 just inside of 6 minutes. You're watching RTC TV4. Hand off to the near side. He's got some room to run. Got a blocker or so in front of him, trying to weave his way down. Solid run for the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Number 45 for the Vikings, Dakota Gaff. It's going to be a Viking first down. Some good blocking out front for Dakota on that one. Gets the handoff off to the far side. First Zebra misses. The second does not. Look like number two for the Zebras. That's going to be Jerry Plummer with a big hit. Second 12 for the Vikings. Hand off up the gut. Nothing doing. Zebras bring him down. Matt Lees in on the initial hit, as well as number one for the Zebras. Hand off to the far side, number 45. Flag on the play. Looks like he slips up after about a 3-yard gain. Holding. So it is holding against the Zebras. It's going to move the ball for the Vikings. Vikings try a run to the far side. Don't get very far. Brings up second down. With 3 minutes 30 seconds to go here in the half. Tie score 0-0. Vikings send a man out to the far side. Hand off up the middle. He bounces around a little bit. Looks like he may have picked up a yard or so before being brought down. Number 24 with the tackle for the Zebras, Harrell. Going to bring up third down for the Vikings. Vikings send a man to the near side. Man in motion. Counter to the right side, the far side. That was enough to give the Vikings a first down. Going to be first and goal. From the roughly the 3, the 5, somewhere down in that neighborhood. Vikings send 85 out to the near side. Man in motion. Same play. Enough for the touchdown for the Vikings. So they were on the board first with a minute 55 here to go in the first half. Vikings take the lead, 6-0 over the Zebras. Looks like Vikings are gearing up for the two-point conversion. Send number 80 to the far side, number 9 to the near side. Hand off to the near side, little pitch. Looks like we may have a face mask there, but he does score. See what they're going to call here. Personal foul face mask against the Zebras. So they move it a little closer. Vikings get another chance to the far side, and that's enough to do it. Take over 8-0 over your Rochester Zebras. Vikings set to kick off. Number 51 for the Vikings with the kickoff. Nice long kick. Big hit. Big hit delivered by number... Can't read it with the glare. I think it's number 25, 35 by the Vikings. Those Zebras get to start off their new drive. Minute 37 to go. Looks like the Zebras are on their 23-yard line to start this drive. Sailors back to pass, almost brought down, trying to scramble away on the far side. Nothing doing. Number of Vikings in pursuit there. That's going to be a big loss for the Zebras. Back from the timeout, Zebras try to pass. Sailors rolls to the near side, taken down. Third down, about 20. Just complete penetration by the Vikings there. Number 54 able to fall on it for the Rochester Zebras. Timeout again. Whistle on the play. Looks like someone false start on the Zebras. It's going to back them up half the distance to the goal line for this punt. Decent punt. Like they're going to spot it right at the 33-yard line. And Valley will have a chance here. 56 seconds to go here in the half. Hand off, 45. Takes it to the far side. Tripped up. And number 80 for the Zebras. There's that 86, Bryce Lehman. Going to bring up second down. 40 seconds to go. Vikings are still huddling. Clock's at 20 seconds. There's the pass to the near side. Incomplete. Clock will stop at 17.9. Bring up third down for the Vikings. Pass, he rolls to his far side, tucks it and runs it. He's got the room. Let's see. Heck of a run by the young man. And they do give him the touchdown for that. My goodness. A great run by the Vikings there with the waning seconds. 5.6 left on the clock. They're going to go for their 2 points here. Pitch to the far side, number 45 with it, and no good. So, 5.6 left in the half. Zebras trailing 14-0. Zebras with a decent return effort there to end the half. They'll go to halftime trailing the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings 14-0. We'll be back after this from Barnhart Field here in Rochester, where the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings C-team is taking on your Rochester Zebras C-team. Ready to start the second half here. Zebras C-team action against the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings C-team. Vikings kicking off. Number 32 for the Zebras. 23. Nice tackle and pursuit by the Vikings. Number 25 with the tackle. 25 for the Vikings. Looking at the roster is Isaac Lau. Or Lowe, not sure how he pronounces it. But a good tackle. 9:53 to go here in the first. Zebras first and 10 from the 25-yard line. Maybe a false start call there against the Zebras. It's going to back him up 5. Going to bring up 1st and 15. Zebras send one out to the far right side. A little pitch. Didn't get him anywhere. It was Justin Riston with the little catch. 29 with the tackle for the Vikings. That being Mr. Jalen Potter. Brings up 2nd down for the Vikings. Or for the Zebras, excuse me. Sailors calls the play, rolls to the far side, still looking to pass, about to tuck it. Flag on the play. Sailors with about a 5-yard gain. Let's see what call is with the flag. Maybe a holding on the Zebras. That's exactly what it is. It's going to back the Zebras up from the spot of the foul. The Zebras hurting themselves right now. A couple of penalties. So I believe it's 2nd and about 40. Sailors back to pass. Pass over the middle. Overthrows all his receivers. Third down now for Sailors and the Zebras. Trailing Tippecanoe Valley Vikings 14-0 with 9 to go here in the third. A couple of big plays really stirred it up for the Vikings. Zebra sent 2 wide to the near side, 2 to the far. Sailor's back, gets a rush, rolls out to his near side. Complete pass to number 86, Bryce Lehman, but there's a loss on the play, or a short gain at best. And it's going to be 4th down and long for the Zebras. We'll be punting from their end zone for the 2nd time today. Last one went to about the 35. Slaps it off the side of his foot there, hits the 30, takes 1 bounce, goes inside the 30, and the Vikings will take over in great field position, just outside the red zone for the Zebras. First and 10 for the Vikings. You send a man in motion. Hand off to number 45. Takes it to the far side. Cuts back. Cuts it back outside. Still on his feet. Did he make the end zone? I believe he did. That is a touchdown signal.
Touchdown to the Kenny Valley, number 45, Dakota Gap.
So the touchdown confirmed. It's now 20-0. Vikings line up for their two-point conversion. Zebra struggled on that misdirection play. 45 able to take it clear around the outside. 45, by the way, we've said his name all night, Dakota Gaff. 34 with the ball up the middle there, and it is good. So 22-0. Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Back to kick for the Vikings again. Not much running room there for the Zebras.
This is return out
to. Was 22 with the carry, Justin Risden. Zebras will start over at their 30-yard line, first and 10. That's Domingo Santiago is the kicker for Valley, by the way. Had to find his name in the roster. Sailors back to pass. Pass is complete. Enough for the first down, it appears. That was Risden with the catch. Oh, wait a minute. 89. Excuse me. Kelton Powell with the catch there, according to my roster. Going to bring up first and 10 for the Zebras, just inside about the 42-yard line. Seen some good plays out of the Zebras today, but a couple of mistakes here and there. Nice swing pass out to the right. Brought down very quickly, though. Nice job by the Valley Vikings there in pursuit. 35 and 25 on that tackle. 25 being Isaac Lau. 35 being Noah Miller. So, second down here for the Zebras. Inside of 7 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Trailing Valley 22-0. You're watching RTC TV. Sailors looks to the far side. Looks like the pass may have been tipped. Not sure. Incomplete, though. That's going to bring up third down. Six to go. The pass was intended for Bryce Baker out in the flats. Option to the far side. They took it too deep, didn't get out far enough. Loss on the play, big loss on the play. Flag on the play as well. Against the Zebras, penalties declined. Going to bring up fourth down for the Zebras. Looks like they're going to punt. Oh, muffed punt. Or a fake, not sure. Came around the right side, but not enough to get the first down. Valley going to take over at the 45-yard line for the Zebras with 6:21 to go in the third quarter. Quarterback rolls out to the right side, just keeps it and runs. Looks like about a 7-yard gain on the play. That was Miller again with the run. And off to the near side, tries to bring it around the corner and does, till they take him out of bounds. Forced out of bounds by Bryce Lehman. Another nice run, though, by number 45. Flag on the play. 45, by the way, is Dakota Gaff. Got a holding against the Vikings. That's going to back them up a bit. Take them back into their own territory, or right at the 50, it looks like. So they mark off the personal foul for the Zebras now. There was a holding and a personal foul. Didn't catch two penalty flags, just saw the one. So ends up taking the Vikings to first down territory, so they'll have to move the markers. Okay, first down, Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. He's back to pass, pass to the near side. Overthrows his receiver. Clock stops with 5:33 to go as the ball was incomplete. Valley sending in a couple of players. Pitch to the far side. Boy, gets a head of steam behind him. Brought down by 72 for the Zebras. Let's give some credit there, number 72. That's Jacob Mark. Well, it comes out one receiver to the near side. Handoff, though, and some great penetration there by the Zebras. Number 70. It's Wes Scobie on the tackle there. Great penetration. Way to wrap him up, bring him down. Brings up fourth down for the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Hand off to the far side, and he's got room again. That place killed us all night long. Worked very well for the Vikings. Jalen Potter on the carry there for the Vikings. So, first down. They can clock continues to roll down here in the third quarter. We're just inside of 4 minutes. Vikings leading your Zebras 22-0. Or your Vikings are leading the Zebras 22-0. Depends on which side of the field you're on. Option keep around the left side. Bootleg more like it. Face mask. So nice run by number 35. Going to tack some on here at the end for the face mask. So the ball's marked just inside the 10-yard line. Going to be first and goal for the Vikings from the 9, 9.5. He rolls, or steps back, excuse me, no roll there. Looks to his left, passes left, incomplete. Good defense by the Zebra backfield. Not sure who actually knocked that down. Maybe number 86, Mr. Bryce Lehman. Regardless, it's second down for the Vikings. Second goal. 3:16 to go on the clock here in the third. Flag on the play. Flag before the play. See what we got called here. They're calling a false start on the Vikings. Looked to be before the play. Not sure. Somebody must have gotten set, or the center maybe even was set and then moved the ball. Still first down. Hand off to number 30. He's headed around the right side, the far side. They force him clear to the sidelines, but he's able to maintain forward momentum, and sure enough, touchdown, Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. Number 30 for the Vikings on that carry. Excuse me as I'm reading by candlelight almost. That's John Humes for the Vikings. So they're going to line up for their two-point conversion here. They're actually going to kick this time. Give it a try. That's number 51. False start again on the Vikings. They're going to back him up 5. Under amateur penalties you see a lot in C-team games, 7th grade games, 8th grade games. They'll get used to it. Once the hand's down, the hand's got to stay down if you're a defensive or an offensive lineman. Muffed snap, calls fire, throws it out, and they pull off a two-point conversion on that reception. Great play by Vikings there in a pinch. Caught the Zebras a little flat-footed. Right now, the score, 30-0, your Tippecanoe Valley Vikings over the Rochester Zebras. 3:06 to go here in the third. Back to kick for the Vikings. Nice end-over-end kick. Fielded by 86 Bryce Lehman. He gets it out to about the 30-yard line where he's tackled by number 35 for the Vikings. Bobbled snap. Flags. Looks like the Vikings recovered, however. Let's see the call here. Referees confer. Hold against the Vikings. That hold will negate the, I believe that will negate the fumble. Oh, still the Zebras ball. Pitch to 22, a little rough on the pitch there. He had to focus on getting it instead of focus on running. Big loss there for the Zebras again. Clock continues to roll with 2:34 to go here in the third. You're watching RTC TV4. Another call. Seen more flags here today than at the UN. Maybe the refs know they're on TV tonight. So, third down 20 for the Zebras. Chandler's with the pitch, steps back. Intercepted. Looked like he double clutched there. Sorry for the camera work. So Valley takes over. First and 10 from the Zebra 31-yard line with 2:02 to go here in the third. Got to be one of the longest quarters we've played all season. Hand off, left side. He's got some room around the corner. Takes it, takes advantage of all the room. Zebra struggled to bring him down right at the goal line. Going to be first and 10 for the Vikings from the goal line. Steps back to pass and then holds on to it, goes to the far side, tries to pass, looks like there was a flag on the play. Looks like the call's against Valley. So second down for the Vikings here. Not sure what the call was. Handoff up the gut, number 45. That's a touchdown for the Vikings. It's going to put them up 36-0 over the Zebras. Just over a minute left here in the third. They're going to try the kick again. Waiting for one more player to enter the scene here. He made it into his position. Mishandled snap, but 51 kicks through it. Nice job. Now it's going to put Valley up 38-0. I apologize, 37-0. It was a one-pointer. See Coach Mitchell and his staff talking to the Zebras. Fundamentals, fundamentals, fundamentals. See what they can do here on this return. Good deep kick, straight to Mr. Lehman. Oh, he's taken down, but that looked like a
Took him down from the head. No call from the referees on that one. He catch the most obscure little glitch of the fingers on the line, but they can't catch the most obvious play that we've had here all night. You won't hear me criticize referees very often, but that was pretty bad. Dive up the middle. Gets him about a gain of one. Was number one on the carry. We've got a name on him finally. Let's pull out our paper, see what we got here. Mr. Number One is Mr. Zach. I can't read his last name. It's dark in the press box now. So good job, Zach Number One. Good hard drive forward again by Zach. Going to be third down now for the Zebras, third and about five. Hand off up the middle, no good for the Zebras. Was number one, Zach again. Getting into it a little altercation. Flags come flying. Number 11 for the Vikings involved in on that. His teammates still having to keep him off. So we'll let the referees confer on this one. Referee's trying to understand what the call's going to be here. Looks like offsetting, dead ball, unsportsmanlike, but I'm not sure. They're moving it back against the Vikings, so I think they're going to call that unsportsmanlike against the Vikings, but they could turn around and march it the other way here. They've done that two or three times tonight as well. Okay, they just offset the penalties. No penalty against the Vikings. Nothing getting marked off. Just switched it for the quarter. Seeing some new things here tonight. Well, we are in the fourth quarter now. Tippecanoe Valley leads the Zebras 37-0. 10 minutes to go here in the game. We're playing under the lights now. As the sun has finally set over Rochester High School to the west. It's going to be fourth down as the Zebras take over here. Zebras set to punt. Waiting for the whistle. You just get the punt off. Best punt of the night. Comes across. Touched by Bryce Lehman there at the 34-yard line where the Vikings will take over.
Thank you.
Zebra's handoff up the middle, number 30, still on his feet. Everything seemed in slow motion. Everybody stopped, kind of stopped. Able to pick up a nice gain, about 5 on that. '79 Dylan Weaver comes out. '73 coming out as well. Blake's handoff up the middle again. Cuts it back to the near side, and he's off to the race. It's only the safety to beat. Tries to get past the safety, can't. But a horse collar is going to be called as he brought him back by the back of the shoulder pads jersey. So that'll tack on some more. I'm going to mark that off. Going to put the Vikings about the 17-yard line. Oh, a little more. Didn't go quite enough, did he? About the 12 or 13-yard line. 8:14 to go here in the game. Tippecanoe Valley leads the Zebras, C team, 37-0. Handoff immediately brought down. A great play by the Zebras. I believe that's number 24. Can't quite see. Bryce Baker on the tackle there. Weaver back in the game for the Z's. Quarterback keep to the far side. Got a little block in front of him. Looks like he was brought down. 86, Bryce Baker, Lehman on the tackle. Gonna bring up third down. Breeze has picked up here a little bit at Barnhart Field in the last quarter. Steady, cool, fall-like breeze coming out of the northwest. Tippecanoe Valley, third down. Lead blockers, everything he needs to score that touchdown. So another touchdown by the Vikings. Number 51 set to kick for the Vikings here again. Called fire. He's trying to outrun the Zebras there. Get in. Zebras make contact, unable to wrap him and tackle him, though. Drew Sailors goes down after that play. Valley scores 2 on that. Going to be 45-0 against the Zebras with 6:30 to go here in the fourth.
Well, that tells the tale of the Zebras right there. Three men on the bench being seen by the trainer. Valley leads 45-0 over the Zebras. Valley kicks off. Zebras were trying to return it, get it out to about the 32-yard line. Check the spot. Zebras with a new quarterback. Able to hand it off up the middle. Just enough to get back to the line of scrimmage. Fumble. Zebras struggle to recover. Recovered by number 66 for the Zebras. Third down for the Zebras. Justin Riston, your quarterback now. Drew Saylor's still on the bench being seen by the trainer. Not much doing there. Going to bring up fourth down for the Zebras. 4:09 left in the game. Zebras set to punt. Excuse me, third down. I think it is fourth down. I apologize. The marker on the far side was not changed. That ball goes out of bounds at about the Viking 35, where they'll take over first and 10 with 3:30 to go. Viking handoff up the middle. Short gain on the play. Going to bring up second down. Hand off. Zebras on a blitz. Can't quite pick him up. They get him after about a yard gain there. 79, Dylan Weaver on the tackle, along with number one, Zach. Clock continues to kick. We're inside of 2 minutes now. As Valley comes to the line. Pitch to the far side. He's got some room and some blockers. And some wheels because he turns them on right there. Number 45 for the Vikings. No flags on the play. A nice run. Stops the clock with 1:33 to go. Kick is up. Kick is no good. So that's going to be 51-0 so far. Kick goes to number 86, Bryce Lehman. Lehman takes it up the middle. He's gang tackled by the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings right at the 30-yard line, maybe the 31. Or even the 32, perhaps. We'll see where they spot it. Minute 20 to go here in the game. Fumble on the play. Recovered by the Vikings. Vikings take over at the 29-yard line. Zebra's 29-yard line. Letting the clock roll down here. I think they might just take a knee. And this one with a 51-0 victory over the Zebras. Taking their time. 28 to go. Number 71 enters the game. Vikings line up. Take a knee, and that's going to do it. Rochester Zebras go down to the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings. C-Team football here on RTC TV4. Score of 51-0. Great showing tonight by the Vikings. Tough effort for the Zebras. Want to thank you again for tuning in to watch RTC TV4 and RTC4.com. I'm Scott Sager. We'll see you next time.